When you're playing Terraria, there's lots of different ways to earn money, from exploring and looting to fighting the awesome bosses in this game. That said, what if you could make tons of platinum while completely AFK? How's it going, crew? This is Happy Days, and today I'm going to show you step by step how to make an easy and awesome AFK money farm in Terraria. I've made some special modifications to this design to boost the farm's earning power by roughly 50% more platinum using some special tricks which I'll share with you later in this video. The first thing you want to do is build a long wooden platform bridge about 3 blocks above the water all the way to the edge of the world. This will make it easy to get your farm started without ocean mobs attacking you. With the platforms finished, you want to roughly locate the middle of the ocean and build a U-shape 5 blocks wide and 1 block up on the left and right side. Make sure you're at least 60 blocks away from the land to ensure that we only spawn ocean mobs for our farm. You can remove the platforms when you're done. Now we're building the most important part of this farm, the mob grinder. From each side of the U-shape, build about 5 blocks down. You'll want the blocks to go about 3 blocks deep into the water, so adjust this as necessary. From here, it's mostly up to you how you design the rest of the mob grinder. I like to build about 6 blocks to the left and right of the base and then zigzag the blocks up to the top. Then connect the blocks back to the original platform to enclose the design. For this farm to work, we need to make a jungle biome using 80 jungle grass or lizard bricks near your farm. To save time and space, I simply build the farm out of mud blocks and will plant some jungle seeds to spread over time. Next, we need to hammer any sharp edges in the water until they're smooth. This will allow the ocean mobs to glide along the farm so they can make their way to the capture area without getting stuck. Now I'm going to share a little trick with you which I recently discovered, which is disabling sharks and jellyfish spawning in the ocean. These mobs slow down the farm, meaning less platinum for you, but thankfully I know how to stop them. Grab yourself a gills potion and start placing mud blocks on the sand in the ocean. Make sure you go all the way underwater and place mud on top of every little bit of sand. A single layer of mud is fine, and when you're finished, place some jungle grass seeds in it. After some testing, I noticed that even though we're in the ocean biome, ocean mobs like sharks still need sand blocks to spawn on, so if we replace the base with jungle grass, we'll only get arapaimas, red anglers, and piranhas. After playing with enough mud blocks to last a lifetime, you can decorate the rest of your farm however you like. I recommend plenty of loot chests, a bewitching table, a water candle, and even a spawn point if you want a quick way to return here. Finally, we place some water in the little U-shape we made earlier and stand in it. Mobs will swim up trying to get to you, thinking you're in the water, but they get stuck in the capture area, ready to be destroyed. Next, we'll need some equipment to earn money from these crazy mobs. I'll show the loadout on screen for you so you can see exactly what you need, and I'll explain why you need each item in a few moments. We need a slime staff reforged to broken, a full set of tiki armor, a pygmy necklace, and a lucky coin which you get from the pirate invasion. If you'd like more info on how to farm rare items, let me know in the comments and I can make a separate video on that. Optionally, you can also use a battle and summoning potion, and they're definitely worth the occasional buff button push as they'll make the farm work so much better. Standing in the water with our equipment on, wait until some mobs swim into the trap and start summoning slimes. You'll notice they start dealing lots of 1 damage hits to the arapaimas, but because we're wearing a lucky coin, each hit can generate extra money that goes to our character. The goal of this farm is not to kill mobs quickly, but for them to spend the maximum amount of time getting hit by slimes to generate tons of platinum, so avoid using damage boosting items, buffs, or banners. After about 5 minutes, we've almost got 5 platinum already, but I'm going to show you how to make this farm even better again. Simply place 300 ice blocks nearby and you'll add the snow biome to this farm. You won't spawn any ice mobs, but you'll be able to get Amarox from the jungle mobs for even more cash. If you'd like this farm to get biome keys as well, then make sure you've got 200 ice blocks either side of your farm and carefully spray each side with purple and red solution to add the corruption and crimson biomes to your farm. Be careful to make sure they're at least 6 blocks away from your farm or the corruption will spread, destroying all your jungle grass. After an hour of farming, you can see we've got a chest full of loot as well as tons of pirate maps to make even more money. Speaking of money, we've made just over 60 platinum, which is insane. What sorts of farms would you like to learn about in Terraria next? Let me know in the comments below. If you found this video useful, please consider leaving a like. For more videos like this, make sure to subscribe and smash that bell icon. And here's the most important part, as always, you'll stay happy and I'll see you soon. This is Happy Days, signing out. See ya!